So we move on with our next rock star speaker. He's a son to a million parents. How would that feel, to be a son to a million parents? Let's hear that from Sailesh Mishra, one of our heroes who's been featured in the Karmakari book. The story is called Son to a Million Parents. And he's going to speak about building a generation-friendly society. Put your hands together for Sailesh Mishra.
What is old age? Anybody? Yeah. What's age?
16.
16 year?
Yeah.
Old?
Yeah, 16
year. 16 year?
Old.
He's old.
Gone. Sorry, I can't ask you age, but can I?
Age is all in the mind.
So. Wow. That's a great answer. Okay. Jimmy sir, what is your age?
75 years young.
And my friend Hari.
44 years old.
Oh my God. He's already old. So aging starts when you're in mother womb. Okay? 1 day you're old, 2 day, 4 day. We celebrate 1 year birthday, 16 year, 20 year. So every day we are growing old. Right? So, but there's a myth. Sir, are you old?
I never considered myself old. You can run with me. I will be ahead of you.
Okay, that's a great answer. So whom do you think is old person? Who? How can you describe? Do you, just imagine your grandfather, grandmother, any neighbor, how he looks.
Wrinkled face, something.
Wrinkle, okay.
How do you? Wisdom.
Wisdom. Ma'am, who is old? Like, you look somebody, the way they walk, the way they talk, or anybody you remember?
Yeah, wiser. Okay. More knowing.
Wow. So many, we have a myth. Okay, sir.
So I have a neighbor, he's 90 years old. So I just asked him, what's the secret of your, you know, age and you're so active? He says, whoever asks me my age, I just say a year younger than you.
Wow. So generally there's a myth, myths of aging, old people have white hair. I think many people have, and many people do die. You know, my daughter is 22 year old. She has white hair and she doesn't die. And some people say you don't have hair. So many people are bald. I don't have a hair, so I'm not old. Wrinkle. Nowadays, youth also have, you know, wrinkles, and they don't have wisdom. Old age is not just about biological, chronological. Is a six type of different aspect: psychological, physical, mental, social, how we grow. That's old age. My journey of 6 years, I'm not going to teach anything, this is only experience, this is only learning. I used to volunteer in an old age home, and there was this lady who was staying there. She has 4 sons. It's pity a mother brings up 4 sons, and 4 sons can't, you know, take care of a mother. We forget, we are growing old, but our mother and father are also growing old. Every month, the son and daughter, like a baggage, put their father and mother in one house, 2 months, 2 months here, 2 months here. They keep on rotating. It happened, one lady was in old age home, and every month you have to pay the maintenance there, monthly charge. The son comes every month and religiously pays the money because he had some issues in the family. Mother is there. And from the office, the mother room is only 100 meter away, only 100 meter away. But the son doesn't go and meet the mother. Just imagine. He comes there, he pays the fees, but doesn't have a courtesy or gratitude or humbleness to go and meet the mother who has given the birth. And we go and ask the mother, aapka beta aaya tha, mila ki nahi? Nahi. Kyun, lekin aapka beta hai? Bahu ka ho gaya abhi. Suddenly, Ekta Kapoor also has become a big picture, pictorial thing, where she has spoiled the image. Already there was a lot of dramatic changes in mother-in-law and daughter-in-law issues. She had made a lot of issues of this kind, and a lot of families, in fact, we get calls, are in this kind of problem. But there are positive stories where youth are taking care of mother and father. All youth are not bad, or all seniors are not good. This is again one lesson. Many people, many youth want to make a change. But how? We blame the youth. You are bad. You're on the Facebook, you're on Twitter, you go to disco or you don't study. But are we spending time with our children about good parenting? We're sending them to Balwadis, the boarding schools, the international school, go abroad and study, 40 years they come back. How can you have an attachment? You have away 30, 40 years from the family, and we expect the child to do something. But seniors also, many people are very nice, of course very lovable, but sometimes they also become so rigid. They keep on nagging children. We need to bridge that gap. We have to enable the youth to come closer and build the capacity of a senior citizen to bridge the gap. Senior citizens should take advantage of the technology. They should use Facebook, Twitter, Jimmy sir is using, and communicate with the daughter and granddaughter. He's here, granddaughter is messaging him, WhatsApp and Facebook is replying. The youth also, they are on computers, and dada dadi are also looking into idiot box, you know, we don't have time for each other. Can't we come ahead? Can we have a rose day for the father and mother? Can we give a chocolate or hug to a parents or grandparents? We do. So many people are doing so many wonderful things. I'm so humble and gratitude, Jerry. It's a wonderful platform. But can't we integrate senior citizen into your all kind of forums? Can we utilize, somebody was talking about the wisdom, experience the elders have. Can we utilize that talent? Is the vested asset of the nation. Senior citizens, they're amazing talent, they're amazing force. Can we utilize them in education? Can we utilize them for civic issues, the environment, creating awareness, mentoring, as Mark was saying? Can we utilize them for schools? Somebody was saying about villages. There are so many retired teachers, retired doctor, retired IAS officer, military people. We need to utilize the talent. And sir, Professor, I like to, you know, have your note on what you have given to government. It was not acted. We will try to make something out of it and see that how senior citizen can be utilized. And believe me, together, youth and seniors can make a change. Youth are catalyst, and seniors can become a mentor to bring the change we all look for. And that is very important. Today's youth is tomorrow's senior citizen. Thank you.
The youth of old age. Very nice.
Yes.
Don't look at me like that, Professor Bangya. You're scaring me now. Okay. All right.
We'll He's a young old. Young old.
Young. 18 till he lives and then he dies. So, right? Rex, that's what we say? Okay. We shall open the floor to questions.
Sailesh, one question I want to ask you. What are your future plan to build the bridge between senior citizen both the generation, rather?
Yeah, that's a very good question. At the silver inning, we're utilizing social media as a very important tool to bridge the gap. 13% of senior citizens are using social media, and 90% youth are using on social media. What we are doing in the last 6 years, we are trying to bridge the gap with social media, with Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, blog, and various other medium, trying to make seniors and junior come to close. Also, we did one program. I think whatever we are doing is it can be replicated. Not just me, myself, and I. It can be replicated by anyone. Jimmy sir has a team called Senior Citizen Mumbai Cricket Champion. I think we should clap for them. They are all 75-year-old young people. They are champion of cricket team in Mumbai. And we had a match. It's called 60 versus 16. We got all the youth and we got a match and they won the match. Youth lost the match with 56 runs.
We won.
So that was one thing. Again, somebody was telling a storytelling idea. I think we had a program called coffee with Kahani. We have lost. My grandfather told me a lot of stories. It was such an enjoyable thing. A lot of mythological or some made up stories. But I don't have any stories to tell my daughter. I've forgotten all the stories. We got seniors together and we named the title as Crazy Love Story. And Jimmy sir, you know, was one of the narrator of his honeymoon story. And the youth enacted in that is a 1 month program. We got youth and seniors together working for the story, and they did with Coffee with Kahani.
What is it called? Crazy Love Story.
Crazy Love Story, Coffee with Kahani. And all the seniors have wonderful stories. You will just enjoy it just to get, because youth need an opportunity also. We can't be away from the youth because, but there are at present 100 million senior citizens in India. In 2050, there will be 326 million and there will be less youth because we have one child or no child, the balance is going to go down. And one more program we have, it's called Silver Inning FC. It's the world's first senior citizen NGO having a senior football club. It's called Silver Inning FC, but all are below 20 years of age. All youth playing football in MDFA Mumbai, having stop elder abuse, playing 16 matches and creating a lot of good awareness. So I think this all can be replicated. And these are some of the things for generation-friendly society.
My submission is it is only the mind and soul and your own inner soul, not soul, inner soul, which will make you young or old.
Yes.
You are as young or as old as you think.
Yes.
So that is why those who work, I am not telling about myself, those who work, they never become old.
In villages, nobody gets old. My mother always, she's 75, she works still. She's happy. In town, we have this Babudam culture of retiring at 60. So I think we should, and there's one good quote, aging is not lost youth, but a new stage of opportunity.
We were talking about bridging the gap among the generations,
yeah.
Correct? The younger generation and the older generation. What I personally feel is that old age is the youngest one can be. Because old age is second childhood.
Yes.
And they are the youngest one can be. If those the people who are into their old age, if they identify themselves with their childhood, remember all the naughty things that they have done in their childhood,
right.
And cherish them even now, they yes. can never, never, never get old.
Wonderful, wonderful.
They can never get old. Wonderful. Old age is second childhood. Let there is a child in every human being,
yes.
And it should be more in the elderly so that they can cherish and age gracefully and beautifully.
Wonderful. Yeah. Wonderful. There is an international study that says if youth and seniors be together, do some activity, it gives a well-being to both people.
Adopt a child, a child from the street, a street child or a child who is orphaned, but we did a little bit of that, but maybe that's another idea.
I need to say two important things. How many people know there is a national policy for senior citizens? Anybody knows? Okay, very few. Please go and read. All the youth, all the young people, seniors forget because your age is gone, I can say. But still, please read the national policy of senior citizen. It's your future, it's not their future. Register your protest because government is not doing sitting on it for last 13 years. And there is a maintenance act. It says if a child doesn't protect or take care of the parent, they will be sent to jail. You can utilize it. You don't have to hire a lawyer. You have to just go to collector office. 90 days disposable. But nobody knows about it. I think we all can make a lot of awareness campaign through it.
Thank you, Jerry.
You're welcome.
It's getting thinner by the day. The thing is that I seen sometime back, Tata Tea had done an ad campaign where they showed a family of orphans actually going out and adopting a parent, which is a reverse concept of adoption. Is that possible?
Yes.
In real life? Is
actually,
something happening?
HelpAge India runs a program called Adopt a Grandparent. But I think we should go beyond because we should not, as our own culture is, we don't promote NGOs or any association. We should ourselves become a change maker. Of course, you can go and adopt a grandparent. There are so many elder people on the street or Mother Teresa kind of home. Nobody to look after, and in old age home also, nobody visits them.
There's no legal issues there.
There is no legal issue. Okay. Of course, if you have a child, you can. Yeah. But I think that adoption, and in US, they have a policy where if you have a house, if you have extra room, give a paying guest to senior citizen, and government pays the subsidy. Government should actually pay, give some subsidy to you to take care of the parent. I think that can be one thing we should look for. Yeah.
So it's not just about adopting. I think the biggest fear for human beings is loneliness, you know, because we are communicative animals, and if we don't have somebody to communicate with, we're almost like in the box, even though we may be living and breathing. So I think it's that. So just going and having a nice conversation with a person.
That's enough.
And we'll have Hunar Brar, our volunteer, give away the certificate to Mr. Sailesh Mishra.